Hey Naturalistas, welcome back to my channel. My name is Nia Hope, and if you're new here or you're not subscribed, make sure you hit that subscribe button down below. So I'm using this Precaxi Nectar Wash and Go Leave-In Conditioner to start off this hairstyle. I did wash and condition my hair. Prior to doing this no gel wash and go, I did apply a clay hair mask to my hair and made a video about it. Make sure you click the link above or below in my description box to check that out. That also helped with the definition. What you see me doing here is making sure that the leave-in conditioner is thoroughly distributed throughout all of my hair. I'm really taking my time with this. I pretty much use as much product as I need to make sure all of my hair strands are saturated. So after that, I'm going in with this frizz-free curl mousse by Shea Moisture. If you're an OG follower, you know I use this on my super short hair alone to achieve curls and it was amazing. But now I'm kind of using it in conjunction with the leave-in, the Precaxi Nectar leave-in wash and go, just to ensure that my hair doesn't frizz up. Because one thing I've noticed, and I'm pretty sure anybody else would notice or assume, is that when you're not using gel, your hair is probably more prone to be frizzy. And yes, it's true. So I'm just taking this extra measure by using this product, which helps with frizz, so that doesn't happen to me. So next, with all wash and goes, when you're done applying all the products needed, you want to make sure first that it's everywhere. You want to make sure from roots to end it's there, and then you want to shake it out. So I always like to slow-mo this part because you kind of see how when you shake your hair, it elongates each strand and each curl becomes separated. And when you're doing a wash and go with or without gel, you do want your hair to kind of clump together in a natural way that defines your curls. And that's exactly what happens when you shake your hair after applying products for a wash and go. Now let's get up close and personal and compare. So on the left is a wash and go with gel, and on the right is the wash and go I just did without gel. You can see that without gel there is more volume, and it is a little bit more frizzy, but that's to be expected. But you still get really great definition. I'm going in with one last product just to guard against frizz as much as possible, because once again, doing wash and goes without gel, it's kind of scary to me because I'm just thinking about all the frizz that could happen that I don't necessarily get as bad with a wash and go when I do use gel or a curling custard. So this is what my wash and go looked like when I was all done. I hope that this tutorial was helpful for you. Again, if you're not subscribed, make sure you subscribe by pressing the button down below. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll catch you in my next video.